Flippa.
Flippa.
DJs, I interview me out again.
Are you guys saying the fact that I triggered her, as you guys say, does that mean it's okay to experience racism as long as you were triggered or as long as you are angry?
No, watch this. The man at XqLusivaSoundsUKTV I represent for exclusive.
What's up?
Baby, let's go.
Welcome to our website. We got loads of news and gossip for you today. But first, here's a new song.
Chica bitch, you want me go go? You want me stripper bitch?
Welcome back, my viewers and my subs, to another hot topic discussion and review. Now, coming up in today's hot topic here, what a Flippa Mafia make hilarious parody of the incident with him and Mavado at Alkali New World Festival. And him also plan to tell it all in an interview on Toxic Talk Postcast.
One bitch named Dick,
I'm here, so this is a brand new one from the artist Popcaan. This one is entitled Why Like a Go-Go. I'm here till it say Popcaan get real ranchy in this one. All the cheer I get it. Poppa Jeezah, with Denyque and Kyla, go do you know?
She was telling us.
She's just telling us that she wants to get eaten like a melon.
But why Popcaan face?
Because he think he's free. I hate the fear.
Probably she want him to eat her, I don't know.
Hey girl, I love talk up your dirty mouth. So me true can read a ribbon.
If I hear them say, your friend wants to see you do good but never better than them.
Also, we're going to take a look at this one where Queen Spice is asking this very important question. Is it okay to be racially abused because you provoke someone? Because as you know, recently, Erica was fired from the reality show that she was on with Spice because she make racial slur at Spice. Now, some people are saying that Spice deserve it because she provoked Erica. Now, Spice is asking the question. I'm going to share it with you a lot and you can let me know your thoughts and comment down in the comment section. More your thoughts on this one. Let's go. Now, before I get into these hot topic, do the honor. Like, share, and also subscribe to the channel. Come here to listen. Pop card is definitely Vibes Cartel son, like father, like son. Got Vibes Cartel would I go do the same thing, put it into the song. But Pop card is definitely the unruly one. Now, the young lady Denyque the other day, she was releasing an album, and I guess you know what I mean. She, I don't know, maybe she'll look some highlight and some promotion, yes, we may say, and some clout. And she could put Popcaan face on her t-shirt, I eat melon. No was expected, the unruly boss never take kindly to it and him send up Denyque underneath her mother. In Denyque defense, she used Kyla line upon him. You understand what I say, people? What Kyla presented on the internet about Popcaan was what Denyque used as her defense against Popcaan telling her about her mom because of she putting him face on her t-shirt, indicating that she want Popcaan to eat her. And now them one call Popcaan the melon man. Poppa Jeezah.
Chica bitch, you want me go go? You want me stripper bitch?
We also have Kyla did a show Panchelli and Correct the other day. And you know what I mean, the topic was Popcaan and melon and all this kind of stuff. And in this song, Popcaan definitely, remember me I tell you, address some people in this one. So we all know who been running off their mouth and Popcaan.
Popcaan might have done the little freaky things then where Denyque could sing about.
Well, I mean,
because you were in a relationship.
Yes.
You had sex?
Yes.
Intercourse?
Lots of sex.
Freaky sex?
Yeah. Threesomes and everything.
And I will also know. Say he mentioned Denyque name in this song. Poppa Jeezah. Bad B Denyque eat the something like a lemon.
Bad bitch named Denyque eat the cocky like a melon.
Now Denyque seems to have responded to Popcaan SES song, but it dedicated to her. Now, the Sing J dropped a photo which had spicy lyrics of her new song. Her post came on the heels of Popcaan teasing the diss track, which featured him singing about what he would do to her mouth. The photo she shared Tuesday evening showed her kneeling on a couch in a grey top and matching tight shorts, with her body turned to the camera, showing off her physique. Interestingly, the attachment song to the post and the lyrics, check it. She don't got a clue. You got a lot of freak in you. Nobody has to know the truth, baby. Poppa Jeezah. Now, this is where Kaila comes in.
Oh, why?
Because Denyque ammunition, what she now firing from Popcaan, actually come from Kaila. Because Kaila did say this, you know, remember?
If you tell me, say, I'm a freak. I don't think you tell me, no.
So, this is why this song is not only dedicated to Denyque, but also to Kaila. Well, you can let me know your thoughts and comment down in the comment section. Popcaan, you the normal. You are really the unruly boss.
One bitch named Dick, deep cocky like a melon. Big dirty thinking free, but you ain't the fear of ones, yeah.
Greetings. In our time, we're seeing and witnessing the rise of Africa, the African continent, that so-called sleeping giant. We're witnessing our people finally ruling their destiny once and for all, putting an end to modern day slavery and exploitation of Africa. We have seen several assassinations since 2020. Now we are at front row at the wind of change. We stand in solidarity. I stand in solidarity with Burkina Faso, with Niger, Cameroon, and every oppressed nation of the African continent. What are we doing here in the region? Let us stand with Africa. The same thing that's happening in Africa is the same that's happening all across the region. We stand with Africa. We stand with those who want to be free, because we know we are not free here in the West. Yes? So we desire the freedom of all Africa, because if Africa is free, then the black man is eventually free. And
now, my viewers and my subscribers, if any of you was wondering if Flippa Mafia was offended by what happened at New Roots on stage with Imam Mavado, well, this snippet says it all.
Flippa! DJ, interview me again.
Now, Poppa Jeezah, if you ask me if Flippa Mafia was offended, of course he was. And if you ask me if Mavado style him, of course Mavado style him. And all of Flippa Mafia fans them see it as well. I would just have to be real about it. However, as you can see, Flippa Mafia is being hilarious about it. There has been a lot of speculation on why Mavado would have style him. Some people are saying because Flippa Mafia reaching out to Popcaan the 876 God on his life on a phone. But as we know, Popcaan and Mavado they're on good term. So the people they must say, right now, Flippa Mafia for choose him side. But why should the man choose side? The man just come from prison, the man not have time with that. The man has say love and peace and unity where is the way forward. You understand? And them little ways they from back in the days, them things they've done. Corner rich now. So I don't know one I will go for. However, my viewers and my subscribers, they say, following this now viral encounter with dancehall artist Mavado, the Flossing King Flippa Magla seemingly ready to spill it all on the incident with the unfinished house artist promoting an interview while parading the viral moment. On Sunday, Flippa Mafia attempted to embrace the gully side DJ Mavado during his performance at Alkaline New Roots Festival. However, Mavado did not acknowledge Flippa Mafia, and the clip of the awkward encounter quickly began circulating online. Despite recently receiving the cold shoulder from Mavado, Flippa does not appear to be taking the matter too seriously. The entertainer reenacted the incident to promote his upcoming interview with Let It Be Honest on Taxi's Postcards, as I'm already telling you. Now, in the short promotional video, Jay encountered Flippa on his way down a street and attempt to greet him, similar to Flippa attempt to embrace Mavado on stage. However, the Demia DJ swerved away from Jay while giving him a dead stare. So as I said, Flippa Mafia is imitating the incident him and Jay about what happened on stage with him and Mavado. And as you can see, when Flippa Mafia serve away and turned around, he was staring at Jay with the dead eyes. And I guess that's what Mavado did to Flippa Mafia, and that's how him put it out there. And I mean, put it out there like that. You understand what he's saying in the video, where Flippa Mafia is imitating what happened with him and Mavado on stage. Now, if you ask me, the artist them, you know, if you leave them thing there out of the thing now, you know what I mean? Because as I said, we have come a long way, and now most of these international artists like Mavado and all of them, they all have money now. So certain animosity amongst each other should really be put aside, and they should be more focused on the music. However, that's how me see it still. Let me know your thoughts down in the comment section. I want you to tell me how you feel about Mavado actions. You felt like Flippa Mafia was wrong for a walk up to Mavado, for embrace Mavado. What are your thoughts? I'm intrigued to know. So, when you talk to me, down in the comment section.
Are you guys saying the fact that I triggered her, as you guys say, does that mean it's okay to experience racism as long as you were triggered or as long as you are angry? We're all in this together, so I'm just asking questions, and I'm not being, you know, ignorant. I'm not playing victim, and I am taking full accountability, because you said, you know, I experienced the racism because I triggered her. So is that a new thing now in 2023? It's okay to receive racism as long as you're angry? I'm just asking. So feel free to let me know, because I'm going to open back the comment section, and I really want to hear from you guys, because I personally believe that this is a big thing within our community. It's a big thing where I don't remember if it's 2018, I did colorism. I painted my face white to protest because I realized, so it's like a prediction, I realized that people prefer a lighter color, and they would pick up for someone of a lighter color over my dark skin any given day, because there is colorism within our black community.
You ever hear that saying? I don't agree with Erica calling you no monkey. I think that's some real bullshit. I don't give a fuck if at the end of the day somebody did talk about your child, the first thing you should jump to is something racist. I don't believe in that. I don't believe that. You don't deserve that.
Now, thanks for watching to the end of today's broadcast. Do like, share, and leave your thoughts down in the comment section. And as usual, it's blessing always. XqLusiva out.